My name is Fatma Ahmed and I'm from Park Turk School. The name of my project is Effect of Indolistic Acid on In Vitro Growth and Biomass Production of Some Soil Fungi. What we have literally done is that we've taken indolistic acid, which falls in the category of auxins, a plant hormone, and we've tested it on four specific type of fungi, which were Aspergillus oryza, Aspergillus cereus, Aspergillus niger, and Alternaria alternata. In the first step, we sterilized all our glassware. We washed it with detergent and water, and then in the next step, we autoclaved it for 15 minutes, and the next step, we re-sterilized in an oven for 30 minutes. Next, we prepared our media plates with 2% malt extract agar, and we left it for the incubation period of 24 hours. After 24 hours, what we did was that we plates showing no sign of contamination were provided with pure fungal cultures obtained from the Fungal Biotechnology Lab, University of Punjab, and then we left it for 7 days. All of the methods were done in a laminar airflow chamber aseptically. After 7 days, what we did was we took the with a sterilized cork borer, we took two discs of each fungi, and then we put them in petri plates containing filter paper, moistened with 10 milliliters of each hormonal treatment, and we left it for 1.5 hours. After 1.5 hours, we transferred these discs to each of the liquid media flasks, and we left it for a week. After a week, what we did was that we took them and we took the fresh and dry weight. For the fresh weight, we weighed them on a Watt number one pre-weighed filter paper, and for the dry weight, we almost heated our matter for six hours at 60 degrees Celsius. The result was that the optimum concentration, we took four concentrations, which was 0, 15, 30, 45, and 60 milligram per liter, and then the optimum concentration was 45 milligram per liter, and the fungi showing the most growth was Aspergillus oryza. Aspergillus oryza is a fermentation fungus used in Asian cuisine for fermentation because it produces amylase protein. It also produces pectin lyase, which is the only known enzyme used to degrade pectin found in agro-industrial residues. Using Aspergillus oryza, we can clean almost 30% of the agro-industrial residues by degrading the pectin lyase, using pectin lyase.